Hello and welcome to Scratch Chemistry. In last video we discussed about the physical and chemical properties of 1,2-diol. In this video we are going to discuss about the one of the most important name reaction, that is pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement. Okay, so in pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement we will cover the reaction, the definition, reaction, the mechanisms, and 2 to 3 reactions, different examples. And we also discuss one most important thing is the factors affecting pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement. So if you see this reaction from exam point of view, if you are preparing for NET, GATE or SET or any university entrance examination, IIT JAM or even in PhD interview, you may get one question from this name reaction. Okay, so let's get started. So first write its definition. So write the definition. In short, DEF. Okay, the pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement is a type of rearrangement reaction where 1,2-diol rearranges to give one carbonyl compound in presence of acid. Right? It is a type of, just write, type of rearrangement reaction. It is a type of rearrangement reaction where 1,2-diol rearrange to give a carbonyl compound. What? A carbonyl compound in presence of what? In presence of acid. Okay, in presence of acid. Okay, definition clear? Okay, so then next is reaction. What is the reaction then? Reaction, in short, REX. Okay, so in reaction, let us take one symmetric diol first. So symmetric diols means the OH group, both the OH group in similar environment. Look at this example. Here both the OH groups are in similar environment or symmetric diol, means here 2CH3, also here 2CH3. Okay, to this if you give acid, in presence of acid, what we are getting? One carbonyl compound. So carbonyl compound is, it will form like this compound, CH3 CH3 CH3. Okay, and this is the reaction. So how to remember this pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement in short form? You can mark the name from its name. So pinacol in pinacol end with OL. OL IUPAC nomenclature is used for the functional group, alcohol or OH group. So here OH group is diol, OH-OH. Okay, next pinacolon. Okay, diol to pinacolon, in pinacolon also it ends with O-N-E, and O-N-E IUPAC nomenclature is used for the functional group for ketone. Here ketone is carbonyl compound. Okay, here is carbonyl compound. So from 1,2-diol to carbonyl compound, this is pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement. In short form, you can remember. Okay, so this is the reaction. So next, its mechanism. What is the mechanism then? Reaction mechanism. Okay, same starting material. This is the starting material. Take symmetric CH3OH. Mechanism is important. Okay, to this we are using what? Acid. Okay, let us suppose take an acid S2SO4, sulfuric acid. If sulfuric acid will dissociate, what it will form? H plus and HSO4 minus. So in short, you can write it as H plus HSO4 minus sulfuric acid. So in the first step, what will happen? The oxygen lone pair in both the hydroxyl group are in similar environment. Any one of the hydroxyl group can take the hydrogen here. The OH, the oxygen lone pair takes the hydrogen. Okay, so what it will form? COH CH3. Here CO, oxygen takes the hydrogen by donating its lone pair of electron. Then there will be a positive charge over oxygen. OH positive, H CH3 attached to CH3. Okay, and this step is known as step 1. Let it be as step 1. And this step one is known as what? Protonation of 1,2-diol simple you can say. Proton group is get attached to OH or it is 1,2-diol, the protonation of 1,2-diol, right? Protonation of 1,2-diol. Okay. So in the next, this is step one. In the next step, what will happen? This is the now starting metal in for step two. CH3C OH CH3 attached to C OH H positive charge CH3 CH3. Okay, so to this, in the next step what will happen? Here is water, you can see OH H positive water, and water is a better leaving group here. So water group releases minus water. If water group releases, then there will be positive charge create over this carbon atom. Just mark my finger, this carbon atom, there will be positive charge, and that positive charge is which intermediate? Carbocation intermediate, or this type of mechanism what we call, this is a SN1 type mechanism, loss of leaving group in the first step, formation of carbocation. This is SN1 pathway, right over it SN1 pathway. Okay, so this step we can step 2, and step 2 we can call it as, we can name it as what? Formation of carbocation by loss of water molecule. Simple, formation of carbocation takes place by loss of water molecule, right? Formation of carbocation, carbocation intermediate, or you can call, name it as carbonium ion. Formation of carbocation intermediate by loss of what? By loss of water molecule. This is the second step, very easy. Okay, so in the third step, look at this side, step 3. In step 3, for step 3 starting material, now this one we have now starting material. So for step 3, right, starting material first, that is the carbonium ion OH CH3. Okay, carbon CH3 CH3, then positive carbonium ion. In the next step, what will happen? Okay, the carbon here is electron deficient because it is a carbocation. So in the next step, what will happen? So here you can see the non-bonded electron over oxygen. Okay, it will return to carbon oxygen single bond to form carbon oxygen double bond, or you can say the non-bonded electron over oxygen donates to antibonding or LOMO of carbon atom to form carbon oxygen double bond. And at the same step, while oxygen donates its electron to carbon oxygen single bond, okay, the bond which is just opposite to carbon oxygen, it will become weak and it will break. Okay, if this bond will strength, then the opposite bond definitely get weak. Okay, so this CCH3 bond get weaker and break, and this bond moves, okay, rearrange, moves and get attached to this electron deficient carbon atom or carbocation atom intermediate. So what it will form? CH3, C here forms now double bond, C double bond O, and oxygen attached to positive. As oxygen donates its electron, then there will be a positive charge over oxygen. So here the CH3 group migrate or shift, or you can say it transfer to this carbocation. So carbon attached to, then there is CH3, then CH3, then CH3. Okay, all of you got. So this is, and this step 3 we can write it as step 3 was what? Step 3, the 1,2 shift of or rearrangement of carbonium ion to form a protonated carbonyl. This is protonated carbonyl. So you can write this step as rearrangement of what? Carbonium ion, here is carbocation, carbonium ion to form protonated carbonyl molecule. In your language, you can write it as protonated carbonyl molecule. Okay. So this is step 3. So in step 4, what will happen? In step 4, just mark, this is the protonated carbonyl compound or molecule. To this protonated carbonyl compound, if it will deprotonate, what will happen? Your positive charge over oxygen is not stable. In the next step, what will happen? Okay, so you can mark in from starting we are using H plus, and in the remaining part will be present in the solution, that is HSO4 minus, that is the conjugate base of H2SO4. So conjugate base of H2SO4 in this step HSO4 minus, what it will do, it is a conjugate base, it will abstract the hydrogen here and this bond moves over to oxygen and makes the oxygen atom neutral. So what is the product now? This is a carbonyl compound. Okay, CH3, just mark this and this, both are same. Okay, so we are getting on carbonyl compound from starting material is what? 1,2-diol by using acid here, H2SO4. So this step 4 you can write it as what? Deprotonation here occurs. So deprotonation of protonated carbonyl compound to form carbonyl compound, or you can write simply as deprotonation of protonated carbonyl compound. Okay, all of you got very easy mechanism. Okay, simple and easy mechanism in 4 steps. Okay, in your language you can write the steps, there is no problem. So guys, note it down or take a screenshot in your mobile, because I have to erase these things for taking examples, I have no space. Let us take a cyclic symmetry diol. Cyclic symmetry diols means example 1, let us take. Examples are for practice only. Example 1, similar reaction mechanism. Cyclic, this is cyclic pentane and OH, this is also another cyclopentane. Symmetric, both the OH groups are in similar environment. To this we are using what? Acid S plus. In the first step what happened? Either of the two hydroxyl groups can take the hydrogen, because both the hydroxyl groups are in similar environment. Let us suppose this oxygen takes the hydrogen. As oxygen donates its electron pair, then there are positive charge over that oxygen. Okay, here also OHH, oxygen donates its electron pair, then positive charge over oxygen. The next step, this is a protonation step. Next step what will happen? Similar 4-step mechanism. In the similar step, water group releases, minus water. Water is a better living group here. So water group releases. This is a what type of reaction? Reaction SN1 reaction. The SN1 reaction, first step living group releases, leads to formation of what? Carbocation here. 3-degree carbocation formation takes place in the next step, that is why it is stable. So in the formation of carbocation, I am writing here. So carbocation is type, here is OH and here is formation of carbocation to this, over this carbon, because water loss from this carbon atom, then there are positive charge over this carbon, 3-degree carbocation. Okay, in the next step what will happen? What I said, here oxygen donates the electron pair to the lone pair, to the antibonding of this carbon, or you can say LOMO of this carbon atom, or you can simply say the oxygen non-bonded electron over oxygen returns to carbon oxygen single bond to form carbon oxygen double bond. Okay, when it returns, okay, the bond, I said the bond just opposite to the OH group will migrate to where? To the carbocation. Electron deficient here is carbon atom, to the electron deficient carbon atom or carbocation center. Okay, this group, this is migrate arrow. Okay, this bond migrate to this carbocation. Okay, in previous example the bond group migration was takes place. Okay, here group, but here the bond migration takes place. Okay, so what it will form? Just write it as here C double bond O form. Okay, as oxygen donates its electron, then positive charge over oxygen, and oxygen attached to hydrogen, and this bond breaks. Okay, this bond breaks, attached, it is disconnect from this center, this bond disconnect from this center, just mark it. Okay, disconnect from this center, but it is stay attached to this carbon atom. Okay, this carbon, and this also, this bond attached to this carbon, just mark, and this break from this side by attaching this side, and here attached to cyclopentane ring. All of you got it or not? This step is important, rearrangement step is very important. So in the next step what will happen? In the next step, okay, so here positive charge, there will be no positive charge as bond migration takes place to that electron deficient carbon atom or carbocation center to fill the vacant orbital. So there will be no positive charge now. So in the next step what will happen? Here you can see the positive charge deprotonation step, the conjugate base remaining is HSO4-. The HSO4- takes the hydrogen and this bond moves over to oxygen. Leads to formation of, this is how many number ring? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is pyrrolidine compound, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 6 membered ring. You can write it as 6 membered ring. Okay, six, no problem. Okay, let it numbering as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, in one position carbon. Let us take this as one position. Okay, carbonyl group C double bond O. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and in 6. This is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And to this 6, there is 5 member ring. Okay. Easy. Very simple. You have to practice this step only. This breaks from this carbon center while get attached to this carbon center. Okay. And this get attached to this carbocation center and makes it neutral. Okay, this is a step. After that, conjugate base takes the hydrogen and makes the oxygen atom neutral. Simple. This is 6 member ring by numbering. This is 5 member ring. Okay, let us take another example. This side, look. Okay, let us take another example. Example 4. Okay, so example 4, in the previous 3 example, what we have taken? The symmetric diol. In example 4, we will take an asymmetric alkyl, means the OH group are in two different environment. Okay, so here is OH and here also two phenyl ring, phenyl attached to OH. Now both OH are in two different environment, asymmetric diol. Okay, to this, in the first step, similar mechanism H plus we are using. So here you have to see which OH group will protonated first, which OH group will protonate. So how to know? We don't know which OH group will protonate it. So let us try by taking both the OH group as protonated. Okay, let us suppose this OH is number one OH, this is number two OH. For number one OH, if it will protonated, it will undergo path one, let us suppose. Path one. Okay, if number two OH will get protonated, it will consider as path 2. We have to choose which pathway is stable so that then we consider which OH group will protonated. Okay, if in path 1 the OH number 1 OH will protonate, is suppose. If it will protonate, what will form OH 2? Similar reaction mechanism is similar, but here is factors we are seeing. PH. Okay, here is similar OH. Okay. In the next step, what will happen? The OH2 group releases, leads to formation of carbocation. Here 3D carbocation, SN1 type, right, is a SN1. So if this OH2 group releases, then what will happen? There is a positive carbocation or positive charge, carbonium ion forms OH, PH, PH. Similar in path 2, just mark. If second path 2 means second hydroxyl group, the second hydroxyl group will protonate, what it will form? OH, PH, PH, and here OH2. In the next step, what will happen? Water group releases, SN1 type, minus water. Okay, what it will form? It will form here OH, here PH, here PH, here carbocation. Here also 3 degree carbocation. We can compare both the intermediate carbocation and intermediate. Which intermediate is stable, so that we can tell which hydroxyl group will protonate it. So just here is this carbon atom is 3 degree carbocation, okay, and 3 degree carbocation is stable, obvious, okay. And you can also see here is also 3 degree carbocation. This is 3 degree carbocation, yes or no? 3 degree carbocation. So besides 3 degree carbocation, we can see here the phenyl group, okay. The phenyl group here is attached to CH2 and positive. This is benzyl carbocation, 3D carbocation, and adding to it benzyl carbocation, we can call it as benzyl carbocation. Also benzyl carbocation phenyl group, the positive charge over carbocation, the carbon atom or this carbocation is resonating established by both the phenyl rings. Okay, so resonatingly stabilized because of presence of two phenyl groups. Okay, there are three factors which contributing the stability of this carbocation here in the path 2. But in path 1 only one factor, that is 3 degree carbocation. So that is why this intermediate is more stable than that one. Okay, greater than. This intermediate is more stable than this intermediate because of three factors: benzyl carbocation, 3 degree carbocation, resonant angle stabilized because of presence of two phenyl rings. That is why this intermediate is stable. Because this intermediate is stable, so that the path 2 or this hydroxyl group, the number 2 hydroxyl group, it will protonated. Okay, number 1 it will not protonated. Which group will protonated? This second OH group will protonated, not 1. Okay, now it is clear the second OH group why it is protonated. Okay, so coming to next step. So this path is not followed. Okay, so write the cross symbol. This is followed. In the next step, what will happen? When the similar step, when the oxygen lone pair returns to carbon oxygen single bond to form carbon oxygen double bond, the bond here is opposite bond, is this one is the opposite bond. This opposite bond migrates to this carbocation to make it neutral. So just write the, so here C double bond O and oxygen donates electron, positive charge over oxygen, and this bond breaks. Okay, it remain attached to this carbon but breaks from this side. Okay, it now it get attached to this side, attached to this carbon, this carbocation. Okay, here is the bond is similar to this. Okay, and this bond attached to now this. Okay, and here is pH, here is pH. Okay, in the next step what will happen? Conjugate base of acid HSO4- or any acid, it will take the hydrogen and this bond moves over to oxygen to make the oxygen atom neutral. This is how many number ring? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can draw it as 6 member cyclic ring. Okay, to this carbon, the carbonyl atom here. Okay, now in the 2, this let us say 1 and let us say 2, in 2 position, 2 pH. Okay, all of you got it? Very simple. What is the product, you know now? So in this is also an important example, okay, in entrance examination, because there are two chemoselective type examples here, which you have to consider which OH group will protonated fast. This is the main point, by seeing the carbocation, the resultant carbocation which is forming stable, so that you have to consider that path only. So now come to the factors affecting. So write factors affecting. This is important, factors affecting. Factors affecting pinnacle and PP reaction. PP rearrangement I can write in short. PP rearrangement. Factors affecting, what are the factors? Let us take an example here. Through example, we will study. So, an example, write pH NO2 here. pH NO2 attached to here. pH ME. Okay, and here is OH, and here OH, and here PHOME. Okay, next here is, let us pH. So in the first step, if we give H plus, so number one factor here, note down, number one factor. So first you have to see which OH group will protonated first. These are two OH groups and both OH are in different environment. Which OH group will protonated fast? How to know? By seeing the resultant carbocation stability. Previous example I have discussed, by seeing the resultant carbocation stability. So write resultant carbocation stability. Resultant carbocation stability. Okay, so resultant carbocation stability, if like previous example, we have to choose path 1 and path 2, then see which path 1, in which pathway the carbocation which is forming is stable. So that we have to choose that pathway only. So let us suppose take this hydroxyl as 1 and this hydroxyl as 2. Okay, if this hydroxyl group will protonated, this is path 1, and if this OH group will protonated, this is path 2. Okay, in path 1, if this proton, this hydroxyl group will protonate, what it will form? Write pH NO2, PHNO2. Here is OH2. This OH will protonated, forms OH2 positive water, then PHME, then attached to PH, PHOME, and OH here. Okay. In the next step, what will happen? The water group releases SN1 mechanism. SN1, what it will form? PHNO2. Water group releases minus water. Okay, PHNO2, PHME. Water group releases formation of carbocation here. And here is PHME, PHOME. It is OME. PHOME attached to PH and OH. Okay, this is one resultant carbocation. If you follow the path 1, means this hydroxyl group is protonated. If the second hydroxyl group will protonated, this is path 2. What it will form? OH, PHNO2, PHME attached to PHOME attached to PH attached to this OH group protonated now. OH2 positive. Okay, in the next step, water group releases SN1 pathway, minus water SN1 pathway leads to formation of carbocation 1 carbocation. OH, PHNO2, PHME, next PHOME, PH positive. Okay, this is another carbocation. Okay, so now compare both the resultant carbocation. Which carbocation is stable? You have to see. So here, see this carbocation, positive charge carbocation means electron deficient. Okay, here this carbon means carbocation, carbon center attached to PHNO2, means nitrophenyl ring. Okay, the nitro group is electron donating or electron withdrawing group. It is electron withdrawing group. It will withdraw electron from adjacent carbon. Okay, first of all, this carbon electron deficient. Again, this carbon atom attached to PHNO2, means NO2 electron withdrawing group. Uske paas bhi electron nahi hai, wo electron chahta hai jyada. To ye compound kya ho jayega? Destabilized ho jayega. Or unstable, you can say. Destabilized or unstable. So this intermediate is unstable. Okay, so this intermediate will not form the product. So that is why this OH group will not protonated. Okay, in the first step. So this OH group will protonated, second OH group will protonated, because the positive charge here, you can see PHOME. This group is PHOME. Okay, PHOME means it is a electron donating, it behaves as an electron donating group. Carbon cation is electron deficient, so it needs electron. So PHOME, what it will do, it will donate electron to adjacent carbocation. Okay, that is why this intermediate or this carbocation is stable. Okay, you can write stable, and the stable the intermediate, it will form stable product. So path 2 it will follow, means this OH group will protonated, not this first OH group will not protonated, the second OH group will protonated. Thus, that is why the first factor is resultant carbocation stability, you have to see. Okay, resultant carbocation stability. All of you understand? I have to erase. Okay, what we have now?
The OH, PHNO2, PHME, and is attached to PHOME and PH positive charge.
And this carbocation is for path 2 or 2 hydroxyl group, is if number 2 hydroxyl group, if it will protonate, this is the resultant carbocation, it will form stable carbocation. Okay, in the next step, what will happen? For factor 2, you can write F2. In factor 2, you have to see which group will migrate, right? Which group will migrate? Which group will migrate? Okay, so here you can see what is the mechanism. While the oxygen lone pairs returns, okay, to carbon oxygen single bond to form carbon oxygen double bonds, the bond which is just opposite, this bond is opposite to carbon oxygen bond. Okay, this group will migrate to this electron deficient carbon atom. Okay, so what is the product then? OH double bond, positive charge over oxygen, PHNO2. Okay, PHOME, PH. Okay, so what factor I have told? The bond which is just opposite to the OH group, right? Bond which is just opposite to OH group. OH group. Or you can see opposite, in case of opposite you can write chemistry term as anti. The bond which is anti to the OH group will migrate. Okay, but another case you have to see, this is PhNO2 is a electron withdrawing group, okay, and PhNO is a electron donating group, and both the group we can consider it as a opposite or anti to the OH group because this is a tetrahedral structure. Okay, so why only PhNO2 group migrate and not PhNO2 group migrate? Here is PhNO2, while it will migrate, it will form PhNO2, right? Why PhNO2 migrate not PhNO2? So because reason is carbon is similar reason, carbocation is electron deficient, so it needs electron. So PhNO2 is electron sufficient molecule, but PhNO2 is electron withdrawing molecule. So PhNO2 will migrate. Okay, then PhNO2. So what we learn here? So anti OH means the bond will migrate, that is anti to OH, but it should be electron donating group. Okay, so right, factor is anti OH. Which group will migrate? Anti OH. Means not anti OH, OH anti group, right? OH anti group, and it should be second factor, it should be electron donating group, EDG, electron donating group. For electron donating group I am writing it EDG. Okay, first condition is anti to OH group, it must be electron donating group, the secondary condition, it greater than OH anti group. Anti group will always migrate, OH anti group, but in second case greater than electron withdrawing group. What is the reason? I discussed electron withdrawing group, EWG, electron withdrawing group. So PhNO2 group, that is why migrate. In the next step, what will happen? In the next step, conjugate base HS support minus, it will take the hydrogen and this bond moves over to oxygen to make the oxygen atom neutral. So what it will form then? Carbonyl compound PhNO2, and also this question came in IIT exam, not IIT exam, particular NET exam, National Eligibility Test, PhNO2. Okay, this is the product what we have got. Okay, so these are the two factors, and number three factors is also there. So I have to write number three factors. Okay, just note it down or take a screenshot on your mobile. We have to erase now. Within 5 seconds, just take a short note. This is the factor two. Factor three, stereochemistry. Okay, in stereochemistry format, we can write this molecule in Weisdes formula. Weisdes means, see here, NO2 pH, let us be in dash form. Okay, dash form, this is dash form, we can write it in alpha form, we can say alpha form, and this is PhNO2 in beta form or wedge form, this is beta form. Okay, and this attached to, this is dot 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 dot. Okay, this is dotted and this is solid. Okay, this is stereochemistry. So here PhNO2, let us this PhNO2 like inside PhNO2. Okay, and this pH is inside too. Okay, and the second step means formation of carbocation step, after that you have to see. So this is the Weisdes formula, or this is alpha Weisdes formula, or stereochemistry wise we write the in the product two, that is carbocation. Okay, in the next step what will happen? When oxygen lone pairs returns, okay, the opposite what we have studied, the PhNO2 group will migrate because it is electron donating group, and PhNO2 group is in which wedge or dash? This is in wedge form, this is solid form. Solid form, we can another form, we can write it as solid form as in beta, we can call it as a beta form. So this group will migrate. Okay, what it will forming? What is it forming? PhNO2 dot 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 dot, double bond O H positive. Okay, and this one attached to PhNO2 pH. So one question is, now the PhNO2 group migrates. Okay, PhNO2 group migrates. So what will be the stereochemistry after the reaction? PhNO2 group after migrating, what will be its stereochemistry before it is in beta, in solid form? So after migration, it will remain as such, means it will remain as also in beta form PHME. That what we called as retention of configuration, means configuration change नहीं होगा. पहले जो भी configuration था बाद में भी reaction के बाद में after migration same configuration रहेगा, ठीक है. So PHME will remain in beta, that is retention configuration. What? Retention configuration means stereochemistry of the migrating group will not change, right? Retention configuration in second point, right? Stereochemistry, what was the stereochemistry? Beta. After the migration, same beta. So stereochemistry of migratory group is PHME. Stereochemistry of migratory group will not change, means which configuration? Retention configuration will not change. If it is changed, then it is inversion configuration, but it is not changed here, that is why retention configuration. So these are the three factors of phenacol-phenacolone rearrangement. Okay, first factor is resultant carbocation formation. Second factor is which group will migrate, means anti, but electron and in the same time it should be an electron donating group, anti to OH. And in third case, stereochemistry. In stereochemistry, the retention of configuration takes place, means stereochemistry of migrating group will not change. Okay, so these are the three factors. Okay, so I assure you can get one question from this phenacol-phenacolone rearrangement in any of the entrance examination. Okay, so watch the video fully. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. Also, you can like the video if you think this video is little helpful to you. Also, you can subscribe my channel, as it will motivate or inspire me to make more videos for you. Okay, see you in the next video. Thank you. Stay healthy, stay happy.